Greetings, folks, and welcome back to the Parkinson's Disease Education Podcast. You may have seen the title of the episode and wondered, what role does really magnesium play in sleep, let alone play in Parkinson's disease as it relates to sleep? That's what we're going to be diving deeper into in this episode and exploring a little bit about how it could be more important than you really expected, even as it relates to Parkinson's disease progression. If that got your interest, I hope you'll stay for the rest of the episode. And without further ado, let's cue the intro so we can get back to that on the other side. Let's go. Welcome to the Parkinson's Disease Education Show, where we demystify the disease and empower you as the person with Parkinson's disease to reach your true potential. The content contained on this show is for informational purposes only and is not meant to be a replacement for information or advice that you receive from your in-person medical or therapy professionals. If you haven't already, I hope you'll consider subscribing. And for an even more personalized experience, please ask us about our memberships. Now, without further ado, let's start the show. Many of you might be familiar with the concept that magnesium could help you with sleep. But have you ever really considered why that might be? I wanted to talk a little bit first about magnesium and how it plays a role in your sleep and circadian rhythm, among other things, as well as then how it could in turn relate to Parkinson's disease and why it might be important to supplement magnesium if you have Parkinson's. Before we talk about magnesium and sleep relations, I wanted to let you know that it is common, and it's a fact, that magnesium is a deficiency that persons with Parkinson's often have. As with a lot of things we've talked about in the past with regard to natural minerals found in the body, as well as certain enzymes and proteins and so forth. Magnesium really plays a key role in our circadian rhythm. If you're unfamiliar with the term circadian rhythm, that basically just refers to the cycle that we all go through a day and night cycle, including our sleep. And your circadian rhythm is regulated by several key neurotransmitters. Melatonin is one, and serotonin is another. Magnesium actually helps with melatonin synthesis by activating the enzymes that produce serotonin and then in turn melatonin. And serotonin is a precursor that you need to produce more melatonin. Magnesium is also thought to play a key role in regulating the nervous system and helping to activate what we call the parasympathetic wing of the nervous system. If you think of our nervous system as two different wings of a bird, you got the parasympathetic and the sympathetic. The parasympathetic is your resting and digesting. The sympathetic is your fight or flight. So, in other words, when we're stressed, we have higher cortisol levels or other forms of adrenaline, and you've got that elevated heart rate, flushing, sweating, things like that. So with parasympathetic, that's what we want for good sleep. We want that relaxing, resting and digesting, lowered heart rate, lowered blood pressure, so forth. We definitely want less cortisol because that's a stress hormone, and of course that can cause more issues with your entire body. Furthermore, there's another really key neurotransmitter that magnesium helps to regulate. That's the production of GABA, or gamma-aminobutyric acid. In principle, GABA is essentially a calming neurotransmitter, or it downregulates things. So not enough GABA can produce things like, for example, Parkinson's tremor. Parkinson's disease actually plays a role in GABA production and absorption as well via dopamine. So as you can see, magnesium really is pretty important with sleep because you've got that kind of a trifecta of effects that it has in terms of helping to regulate the nervous system, helping to synthesize melatonin, and also helping to regulate the production of GABA. Now we all, at this point I would hope, know that Parkinson's disease really does cause a lot of sleep problems. Parkinson's disease in itself can cause problems with insomnia and other sleep disorders, and the medications can also play a role in those sleep disorders, ironically. So magnesium also can play a role in terms of supplementation with helping in some of these sleep disorders. I wanted to highlight a little bit of that for you really quick. So we just mentioned GABA a little bit ago, and with dopamine being deficient in Parkinson's disease, the nervous system is not as well regulated for relaxation because GABA is not produced or absorbed quite as well because of lack of dopamine production. So magnesium can play a role in helping, again, to regulate the GABA production and absorption, and can help relax and calm down the nervous system a little bit. And that's for speaking for general insomnia as well as what could be Parkinson's related insomnia. Restless leg syndrome is another common issue that people deal with. And RLS can be related to Parkinson's disease, although they may not share a common link. Regardless, RLS seems to result from overactivation of nerves, whether it's sensory nerves or motor nerves, with involuntary twitching and so forth. Magnesium could actually play a role in relaxing the muscles, calming the nerve signals down, and preventing or reducing cramps. Finally, we need to mention REM sleep behavioral disorder, something that came up in my research on this topic. REM sleep behavioral disorder is where people with Parkinson's and or Lewy body dementia may act out dreams, not just living the dream out in their mind, but actually physically acting them out. And that can cause a lot of problems, as you might imagine. So magnesium may play a role with RBD as well in helping to calm the nervous system, as we mentioned before, and keeping the person and their nervous system from being quite as active while dreaming or sleeping at night. And of course, that research is still emerging, but I would like to hopefully learn that there is a connection. If so, that would be a nice way to treat it. Finally, I just want to put in a quick word about magnesium and its potential role as an antioxidant. As we've heard many times before in this podcast, oxidative stress is not only a causative factor in Parkinson's disease and aggregation of alpha-synuclein, it can also contribute to the continuation of disease progression. So reduction in oxidative stress in whatever way, shape, or form we can is really important. So magnesium may actually play a role in that, in addition to all the other supplements we've talked about previously. So a neuroprotective effect is a great potential benefit of magnesium, and that's something to consider as well. But there's one really important caveat that I have to mention before we conclude this. You definitely want to consult with a physician before supplementing magnesium. And the reason I say that is because excessive magnesium supplementation may actually interfere with your Parkinson's medications directly. And obviously, we don't want that. Also, if your magnesium levels aren't deficient, you probably aren't going to want to supplement a whole lot either, because you can always have too much of a good thing. A lot of what normally you would think would be helpful for the body in excess can actually turn into a toxin. That said, it could be a viable supplement for you, so definitely consult with your physician, primary care physician, or it could be your neurologist as well. Before you really start to dive into supplementation, I would definitely check with a professional. But I think that in many cases, they would agree that it's something that's worth trying and it's probably going to be safe. Now, really briefly also, I wanted to mention the most common types of magnesiums that might be the most beneficial as a person with Parkinson's to look into and to consult with your physician about taking. So there's three different types of magnesium that you might see most commonly when you're researching this. There's magnesium L-threonate, magnesium L-theanine, and finally, magnesium glycinate. Now, magnesium glycinate is said to be the best among those three for sleep because it tends to be absorbed the most quickly. Although I would argue that it probably depends a little bit on the form that you're taking, whether it's like a capsule versus a powdered form, etc. I'm going to leave a link to one example of all three types in the description below this episode, and that will give you an opportunity to look at those, and you could choose, of course, any other ones that you find. These are Amazon links, so you don't have to use Amazon as the source for this, but it does give you one option to find something. But again, I want to stress, do consult with your physician before you take anything, especially since with the potential of magnesium to interfere with Parkinson's medications, you definitely don't want to create a problem by trying to solve another. That's going to conclude our episode about magnesium, Parkinson's, and sleep disorders. I hope you enjoyed it. Please, if you did like the video, share it with other people. Leave your comments below and let us know what your experience is with taking magnesium supplements. As always, thank you for being here. I look forward to catching you in the next episode. And as always, be empowered.